And here you can see I
work to do.
This is the armor I just stole in the previous video, right there. And you can see it shows up, all the components show up as red. That means you've stolen them. These are not red, they're green. These were taken off, these were looted from a body, and these one will be considered stealing, so if you have any companions that don't like stealing, they'll be unhappy. Keep that in mind. At least it has for me. Here's the bar again. And you can see they're all milling about. Not one of them sitting down. They just stand around. Why I bother making them furniture, I don't know. It's the middle of the night. I wanted to show you what Sanctuary looks like at night. You can see I have power to all the houses. And I've put, these are the, you know, power pylon things. I've put a couple of lights on each of them to act as street lights. I'll be building down here, even though I don't, you know, need it, but I won't save this, so once I'm done. I'm going to, I prefer to build in daylight, so I'm going to come in here and alright, we'll just sleep for a few hours. Sometimes this takes forever. Well, there you are. Hi. Good. You're just in time. If I can ever wake up, my character's asleep. There we go. I wanted to wait till daylight. Come on. Time with quick say. All right, that's daylight enough to get started anyway. People sitting around.
Yes?
You have no privacy. That's why I made an island with only me. So, 82. Their happiness is 80. Okay, we're gonna come down here. Unless, I'm gonna make it less, a little less ugly than this. And I'm also gonna do very, very simple. First thing you need is structures, wood, prefabs. We're going to come up here to hallway end, turn it so it's facing this way. Okay. Now I'm going to, see, I guess I'll do it on this side. I'm going to try and get this to line up and be all nice and square, so I'm not the best at this, but we'll try. See how that looks. That's not terrible that way. Okay, right. First try. Alright. Of course, you won't have these lovely foundations at other settlements unless you build them using the foundation thing. Now, start, get another one, get it going the same direction, and then snap them together. And another. Oh, I forgot to place it. And now there's a. Okay, there we go. Hurry up, get through there. There we go. Okay. Okay, and unfortunately in this particular block, this shrub bleeds through a little, but nobody's gonna care. So now they're all, you can see they're all nice and, I've already got a generator out here. I did an experiment last night to see how this would work, and I forgot to store the generator. Oh, yes, you can build your own foundation. Here, I'll using the, oops, again, wood, go over to floors, and this is shack foundation, so you can, and they will also snap together, as you can see there. So yes, you can build your own foundation to have a nice flat surface to start with. It's just that Sanctuary has four, I believe, two or five. It's nice. It comes with these, of course, were houses that I scrapped right at the beginning. They were houses that were collapsed. Okay, so now you got these are four little. These are going to be your bedrooms. Hang on a second. Now, early in the game, you probably won't need this. You may never need this, but I'm going to also put four hallways. You can see it's right next to hallway end, in front of the hallway ends. This just makes each individual unit. This is really, it's not so much an apartment as a cheap motel. Really cheap, really small. All right, now getting a second floor is trickier. As you can see, you can place these things up here, but they don't snap into place to make it nice and square. So what you need to do is come down here to floors again and over to stairs, a little shack stairwell. I'm gonna put mine here. This will add sort of a guideline for the second floor. And now, if I come up here, I can get this hallway. Oh, maybe I can't. I'm going to place it and then grab it and move it until I can get it to snap. Of course, now I'm too close. There. Okay, now see, it's snapped into place next to the stairwell, which of course is snapped onto the lower level, so that when we come down here, you can see it's perfectly... It's as though it had snapped into place. And then, behind that, you can add the hallway end and get it to snap in. Of course, you want to make sure it's facing the right direction. Oh, good. It got it to face the right direction. And from there, it's just a matter of... Oh, you want to add regular floors down here. Come on. No, snap in up here. There. So you have someplace to... for them to walk to get to their rooms. These are the hallway ends. Come on, get in place. And then hallways. Okay. So now you have all the rooms. Next, we're going to wire it for power. And again, you just need a small generator. Come down here to power. And connectors and switches. The first one you want is a switch. Put it up near the top of the first floor. Then we're going to go with these little conduits. I put them in the middle of each block. You don't want to get them too far apart. The shorter the wire between them, the better the power seems to stay connected. Why didn't I... Oh, well, here. Connect, of course, the... Oh, that's not right. See if I can grab that wire. Yeah. connected to your electricity. Now you're all powered up so that when you come in here, you can add light bulbs. You can add any kind of light you want, but I make these pretty bare. And this will... And the reason you put the... I put the... those connectors... high on the wall is so that the power also reaches this floor as well. Oops. Okay, that's that. Okay, now let's furnish. Now we got light. They'll be happy with that. I'm going to furnish the one that doesn't have a shrub in it. They like decorations, so let's... Let's see, I built one of these yesterday. Which painting did I use? It's not going to tell me. Alright, we're going to use a... some sort of deer thing today. Moose, I think. Just for fun. A single painting will keep him happy for a while. And we'll do beds. I use this third bed because it's smaller than the others. And it will... you can get a couple of them in here without making it too crowded. Of course, I have now 35 beds in this settlement, and only 31 people, which is the max I can have. But they were complaining about beds earlier, so now they have more options. I'm going to give them someplace to sit, and I'm going to use a different kind of sofa this time. I had it built. I don't know if I scrapped it or saved it. There it is. Good. Okay. I'm going to use this kind of sofa. And we'll give them a little table. Actually, I'm going to do it differently this time. This table is nice and small, but a radio will not fit on top of it. So use this table. Where's the front? There we go. I'm going to put it here. Radios are over here. Make sure I get the right kind this time. Whoops. That is classical. There's Diamond City. Okay, and then down here I'm going to put... ugh, I can't remember where it is. It might be under power. No. It's got to be under decorations. No? See, it's been a while since I built one of these. Let's try miscellaneous. There we are. Okay, I'm going to put in a TV. Even though the only channel on, and again, you've got this unit powered, so the power on the TV comes on, which is, you know, nice. Even though the only show on is the Please Stand By channel, but anyway, that's, you can then furnish the whole thing in a similar manner, and that will get you, you can put, you know, two beds per little unit here, and that'll get you 16 beds for 16 settlers. Oh, I want to show you how to... you can get settlers by... this one is under power. Miscellaneous. The recruitment radio beacon. It's under power, miscellaneous. It requires only one power. Why I actually built it, I don't know. And then you just, you know, hook it up to the electricity. And bam, now I have two in Sanctuary. But, and then people will start showing up. So you want to make sure that you have everything ready for them before you set out your beacon. Make sure you have food crops prepared for them to start harvesting, and plenty of water, and, of course, beds. Make one bed for each settler you expect to get. Oh, I forgot to show you. Your settlers will climb up here and fall off. So if I build a third level, they could actually potentially die. They are not smart. Settlers are unfortunately not smart. And of course, when running around doing things, you could also fall off the edge. So I put in, again, this is under miscellaneous, under wood, railings. Now you could put, I'll show you here, walls if you wanted. I can get this one to snap in place. And just wall this all off all the way down. And then you could put in a roof as well. The roofs are really ugly though, as you can see. And see, there's a settler. I don't know how she got up there. There are no stairs to that roof. How she got there, I don't know, but anyway, you could do that. That's what I did with that block over there, and you can see how ugly it is. But I don't know how she got off there, and she might fall off and injure herself because, again, they're just not the brightest bulbs in the lamp. Anyway, that's there you go. That's how to make a simple apartment block. Now, as for settlers, here, let me get out of this. You can have as many settlers as your charisma. Actually, the base is 10. You can have 10 settlers per settlement, plus your charisma. And right now my charisma is 3. That's because I'm wearing 3 items that give charisma. I'm not sure what these other bonuses are since the XL wore off some time ago. You, however, how to get. Oh, come on. I'm gonna boost my charisma as high as I can. This is how I got 31 settlers at Sanctuary. Start off though, I need to make a drug. I can't remember which one. I think my chem station is down here. Oh, no, it must be the next one. I almost never use my chem station, so I have lost my chem station. That'll teach me.
The open road and a loaded weapon.
It's next to the cooking station, which I also never use. But up here, there it is. Okay. All right, drug. It's, yeah, grape mentats. You need a hub flower. Those things are scattered all over the wasteland. Two of those, one set of mentats, and a bottle of whiskey. We're gonna make it. Then I'm gonna. That'll give me a +5 to charisma, which is a huge bonus for a limited time. I think it also gives a bonus to buying and selling whatever. Let's see. Oh, I gave away my only clean suit. I'm never gonna find him again. Let's see what else I can find here. Something that adds to charisma. Yeah, this adds to charisma. Okay, good. I don't think I had. I don't think there are any hats. I forgot to look for glasses. If there are any hats that add 2 to charisma, I haven't found them or noticed. And I. There we go. Fashionable glasses. Oh, that only adds 1 to charisma. I thought it added 2. Good. I hate them. They're ugly. So we'll just wear what we're wearing. Over here to inventory. I'm going to put on. There. Now, as you can see, right now I have a +4 to my charisma. That comes from the glasses add 1, this checkered shirt and slacks adds 2, and the hat adds 1. So +4. And of course, I've maxed out, so it's at 14 right now. If I take the mentats, it'll be up to 29. There has got to be something else that adds to charisma because I had it at 31. Well, I guess I can't show you how to get 31. I can show you how to get 29, though. And again, you have to, max out your stuff. But now, if I take the Great, there it is. Oh yeah, 10%, buy for 10% lower and sell for 10% higher. Now I don't want to do this here. If I was actually going to do this, pick the settlement you want to do this in. For example, I could do it at my Starlight Drive-In. Right now it has 23. That's my normal max number of settlers. Is 23. And again, it's 10 plus your current charisma. And here I am drinking coffee, which is already cold. I have to warm that up. Alright, so the first thing you want to do, I could easily expand this. I've already got a three-story, although we saw yesterday that I don't have enough beds in it. I never finished it. But if I wanted to do this, I've got 26 beds right now, 23 people. So I could add three more people here if I could boost my charisma, which I would do with those mentats. So 32 food, 33 water, so there's plenty. Right, oh yeah, 16's quite a lot. You could definitely. And then with, you know, I know you've got a clean suit, I think. That'll add charisma. But the thing is, and you could, I don't know if you have the whiskey to make that drug yet, but that'll add 5, but only for a limited time. So what you would do is, you need more than one settlement, of course. Here I've got this one set up. I could add 3 more if I wanted to, if I had boosted my, took that drug, but just setting up a beacon won't do it. The drug won't last long enough for the beacon to attract settlers. So you go to a place where you already have lots and lots of people, for example, Abernathy Farm for me. I have the beacon, I leave the beacon on here as well. And then when I want to make a big settlement, I get one set up. And then I go to Abernathy Farm, where there are plenty of people, and lots of them are unassigned. You don't want to send an assigned settler to a different settlement. It'll just make them all confused. And of course, you could, you know, end up wrecking things like supply lines or whatever. Fortunately, with the update, it'll tell you what people are assigned to. This guy's assigned to, you know, guard duty. It didn't before, which was really annoying. It made it really hard. But see, this guy's unassigned. I could send him to... So that's what you do. You take that drug, so now your maximum number of settlers at any settlement is higher, and then you select move and tell him where to go. For example, Starlight Drive-In. And then he'll go there. And you keep counting your head how many you're sending till you get the number you want there. And that's how I got 31 people at Sanctuary. Now who's attacking? Someone out here, looks like. Oh, I'm sure it's a bug. Insects are out here all the time. Those bloatfly things. You can see I have everyone here wearing road leathers. So it's kind of like a raider settlement.
Yes.
And I have a lot of, well, here, 50 food, 48 water, more than enough. Defense is, you know, barely. I've got 98 resources, combined resources 98, 105 defense. So it's, but they managed to survive. This is a glitch I haven't been able to fix. These plants were destroyed in an attack. I should be able to repair them, but it won't let me. I hit the button, and it says I don't have the components. Well, I've got all kinds of them in the workshop. I put them there myself. So, I don't know, it just doesn't like me. I've also put because I have so many people here and I need things for them to do. What, are these broken?
Ugh.
Why won't it? Oh. Hmm. Okay. Those two aren't broken. But anyway, so I put one of every kind of shop. I've got the bar back here near tables so they can congregate after work. One or two of them might sit down. The rest, of course, stand. They love just standing around. Don't know why. That could be. I hadn't thought of that. I should try. Wow, that's ugly. I am changing clothes. Let me get my tuxedo back on. There we go. I won't be saving this when we're done, so I can do anything I want. Let's see if I... They should be in this workshop. I might have put them in a different one, but we'll see. Here, just go over to aid. Oh, they aren't here. Well, they're in a different workshop. I don't want to go searching. But anyway, I would show you how to, if I had them repaired, I could show you how to store them. You can't store them once they're ruined, though. You have to repair them first. And then you can store them in your workshop and plant the kind of crops you actually want. Which is not pool cues. Don't plant pool cues. Never works out well. Anyway, here, you can see this is what the ugly apartment block looks like without exterior walls on the upstairs corridors. Of course, you see I used the puppy portrait for each of them. Now I've got little radios.
Our superior technology represents...
Oh, spoilers, don't listen. That's my the main character, the sole survivor, on the radio. I guess while I'm here, I can show you something you may have missed in Concord. It's easy to miss. I missed it for quite a while before I stumbled on it in the guide that I had bought. So, and in fact, I think in it there is one of those potatoes I can try and... And the load screen takes freaking forever. I'm not sure why. Other than it's, you know, a PlayStation. And Xbox is no better, I'm told. Okay, you remember Concord? Here it is. I've recently looted, so there's nothing here to grab. But now, if you remember, big puddle. I don't like walking in that. That's where the raiders spawn, down there by the museum. That's the balcony where Preston was standing when you first met him. If you come down here, not only do the raiders respawn, but all the stuff respawns. See, here's weapons they've left behind and their bodies disappear. And around this area, you remember you found your laser musket here, with the body of a Minuteman, and three power cells, fusion cells for the musket. Also works for laser rifles and such. Those also respawn. I picked them up earlier, though. But they do respawn, which is good. Anyway, down here is where you first saw the Deathclaw come climbing out of... Fortunately, he doesn't respawn. This hole... in the street. Now, what you may not have known is you can actually go in here and discover this is the Concord Civic Access. Come on. Which are basically like maintenance tunnels under the town. Oh, I've got some things spawning. How nice. Anyway, I'm not gonna keep any of this. Through this hole, well, I don't want to give spoilers. Just be careful when you're down here. There are actually three access points. There's that big open hole, and there are two others that are like in little alleys in the. But there's all kinds of stuff down here, including a fusion core, if you can find it. It took me forever. It's not in a fusion unit thing, like all the others. But then there's stuff here. There's danger you'll encounter. I won't tell you about it. You can probably guess from these holes, though, but there are monsters you want to fight. Here's one of the other exit points. This one comes out. I'll show you where it comes out, and then we'll... good question, McCready. Let's go find out. I mean, the fusion core, it's like lying on the ground. It's and behind something, so you have to keep looking until you can find it. It drove me nuts trying to find it, just from the description in the book. And you see, this is a... There's the little doors. Easy to miss. And this is the little alley. Again, that's where you approach from Sanctuary. There's the museum. And this is a little alley with a toolbox respawning stuff. And then there's these doors here. So another way to access the tunnels. If I remember right, that potato I wanted to grab was right up here. I looked this morning and saw, there it is. Okay, if I can get it. Yeah, there we go.
Concord's above us. What are we doing down here?
You already said that. And of course, there are unfortunately people here from before the war that didn't make it. And here's somebody from... Oh, yeah, that's right. You can't jump down here. I always want to, but you can't. You can jump down here, though. Here's somebody who is from after the war, a raider. His body doesn't go away. I have dumped him in the stream many times. There's some drugs, and I think there was a magazine up on this thing. And it is really hard to get to. You can see, jumping up here is a chore. Here's what I had to do. And unfortunately, I left the cone up there, so I have to find another one. There's one. Grab a cone. Oh, come back here, cone. And carry it over to this side of the wall. Put your back to the wall and put it down as far as you can. And hold it down. Hold down while you jump. And of course now it won't work. I'm bad at this. This is a, I'm told, a glitch. Why am I hidden? Stand up. There we go. Hold the thing backwards, so you're moving backwards, and jump. Come on. No, not like that. Over here. Stay here. Keep your back to the wall. And... I did it this morning. Anyway, if you should slide up the back of the wall. Your back should slide up the wall until you are over the... I'm just not doing well tonight. There we go. Made it. And this time I'm going to drop this off the... Oh, no. Drop it off the edge. It won't... Come on. Oh, well. There's a chem box here, and there's some chems in this corner. And I think one of the perk magazines is up here. So it's really a pain getting up here. And I think the other exit is... Oh, no. There's more stuff to loot in here. opening a lovely steamer trunk. Okay, here's the other exit. We'll see where this comes out. There are other places, a couple of other places to explore in Concord. I don't know if you have, but you should. They're fun. And once the raiders are taken care of outside, there is nobody inside. This is next to the Pulaski Preservation Unit. See, there's the museum again, a church next to it. Third access port for the tunnels. Okay, other things that you want to explore, definitely. This is the back door of the Concord Speakeasy. I'm not going to go in there. If you haven't been there, I don't want to spoil it. It's fun. And there's loot. This is a building. I've never found anything in anything in here. Just a big burned out building. But coming through it and going, whoops, there, to this blue door. This is the workhouse. And again, there's loot in here that you want to get. And a fun... You know what? I'm not going to show you. You should explore on your own. So, if you haven't been to these yet, you definitely want to. They're in Concord. And the loot in both places respawns. Early in the game, I hit these things like once every other day just to grab stuff. There are also two houses right on the edge of town, the north edge nearest sanctuary, that respawn stuff. And you can see Red Rocket up there. That's the first house. Actually, it's the first house I'm going in. Let me in. What's going on? Where are the... Okay. It has a... There's a suitcase that you'll often find clothes in. Dresser never has anything. This dresser might. There we go. And a safe. Wow, I suck at lockpicking. I don't know how many bobby pins I broke before I managed to get lockpicking up as high as it will go.
Teach me that sometime.
Sure, MacReady, whatever you say. There's no second floor to this house. Come out the back door and down the stairs, and under the steps you'll find a toolbox. Okay, run straight across from that. Again, there's Red Rocket. To this house. This is the other house that... The only two houses you can get in, and fortunately the stuff respawns, and here's the treat. I got it this morning. I forgot I was going to show you this. There's a Nuka Quantum that respawns in there. And then you can come upstairs. These goggles, bandana, bobby pin, and ashtray respawn. So you can take them and come back later and they'll be there again. And then there's a chem box over here. So these all respawn. This is how you can... I have never been over in this corner. Would you believe that? There's a bobby pin box and a safe, and I have never been over here. Unbelievable. After all the months that I've played...
That's it.
How sad. Well, how about that? The blood bugs that hang out by this Brahmin corpse also respawn. Fortunately, I've got a machine gun up here. So if they get out of line, the guns will shoot them. And you see another Shack Foundation. I really like using these for raising up weapons. My little trading area shops at Red Rocket. I've seen videos online on YouTube of people who have built just the most incredible amount of stuff on top of Red Rocket. Just built up. Oh, that's right. He doesn't actually talk. He beeps. You can, I should show you how to... all the things you can do to a robot. Well, here, let's take the fast way. Which is actually a slow way because of the load screen, but... you can... The customization of robots is just incredible. The things you can do. There's like four or five main bodies you can choose from, and you can mix and match parts off all of them. There we go. And I'm going to make a new one. You start off as an automatron. And you can rename them. This one's new name is... we'll make it really inventive. This is a BotBot. And all the components that you start with initially are Protectrons. So this is a basic stripped-down Protectron when you start. But you can give it all kinds of different heads. Assaultron, Centron, Robo Brain, and Assaultron. So we'll give this one a Assaultron Brain. Now I should say that you'll find a lot of these mods, well, some of these mods, during the Automatron. DLC quest. When you fight robots, you can often pick up, looting their bodies, you can pick up different mods. And you can give them armor. Various different sorts. Here's one that uses a skull. Kind of nasty. And again, it starts with a Protectron body, but you can give it a Mr. Handy. Now, the problem is the Mr. Handy torso will make the head disappear. You won't have a head anymore. So, but you can give it any kind of body you want. And it also, you can give them armor, of course. And there's different sorts. Some are really nasty. Some of them give, like this one makes targets bleed. And some of them, let's see if I can find one. This one irradiates your targets. Melee targets. And they look really, you know, nasty. I don't mind using up my components since I'm not saving this. Here, let's see, that's what the front looks like, that can give them some rear armor. This one will give you better carrying capacity, so you can, you know, use them as a pack mule while you're out. This one will poison targets. Yeah, that looks nasty. And you can give them all kinds of... the torso, you can give them a different mod. This one will let you... he will hack computers for you. This one he'll pick locks for you. Which is, you know, nice. You don't have to spend your time doing that. Or use up your bobby pins. I put the hacking module on R2 because, well, R2-D2 was pretty much a hacker, right? Okay, let's see. Again, it starts with a Protectron arm, but you can give him any kind of arm you want. The exception is, oh, what do I got? Codsworth is. Mr. Handy. They don't have Mr. Handy arms, unfortunately. Kind of sad. And they also get fun armor. Here, turn so you can, oops, so people can see armor. It's all, you know, nasty. You can change their hand. There's a baton. Where is it? It's like stuck inside his chest. Weird. Because it really is. I would spend all day just building robots if I could think of something to do with them other than leaving one at each settlement to... Yeah, that'll be a... It's a hand shock. This one will fire, like, smoke grenades. Poisonous smoke grenades at the bad guys. Which obscures your vision as well. So when you're out there trying to fight the same guy, suddenly he's engulfed in smoke. So it's a mixed blessing. But you can, you know, there's a cryo jet. Anyway, so let's move on to legs. And the great thing is you can give him Mr. Handy Thruster, so he's basically a floating robot, which is great. I love doing that one. Originally I had given R2 this, that little R2 thing that I built, and then I decided, you know, let's try and make him look a little more like R2-D2. He has to at least have treads. And finally, oh, not finally, you can give him a voice, different voices. This is the one I gave R2. Many of the ones that I built and sent out in the Commonwealth have a click or the dark voice, which is fun. Give it a female voice. Give this one a female voice, just for fun. And finally, paint. This is what it looks like with no paint. But you can paint them different colors. Unfortunately, you can't use the fun paints that you find for your power armor. Because that would be fun, like that pink, or that, well, there is pink, but it isn't pink and white, like the power armor one. Red, white, and yellow. But, like, flames, it'd be nice to be, you know, be able to paint flames on your... Manila is the color of normal Protectrons, I think. I'm gonna make this one pink, just because. Okay, and then when you're done, back out here.
You're making that look easy.
This unit is currently in factory default mode. Do you wish to enable this unit's personality subroutine?
I always do. I don't know what happens if you say no. Let's find out.
Nah, I think I'll keep you in default mode for now.
Acknowledged. You can enable this unit's personality subroutine at any time by utilizing the vocal interface.
Oh, so
identity,
I guess nothing.
Confirmed. This unit is ready to serve.
Now you can take him as a companion and have him go along with you, or you can, by going into workshop mode, you can send him to a different settlement, or you can take him as a companion.
Acknowledged.
And now I have to send poor MacReady somewhere. I don't think I can send him here. Oh, I guess I can. Good. That's right. They don't count against your...
Make a whole lot of money. What's happening, cowboy?
And I'll talk to
awaiting
him.
Awaiting instructions.
Oh, wrong button. There we go. Talk.
Hold up a sec.
This unit is at your command.
You see, it just looks horrible with that skull head. But now you can dismiss him.
I no longer require your services.
Returning to origin.
And here, I'll send this one too. Now I've got a second robot living at Sanctuary Hills.
Something's on your mind, just let me know.
And then I can pick...
Hey there.
Pick him back up. He disappeared. I hate when it does that. Now, he's around here somewhere because I told him to go live in... Or did I send him home? No, I can't remember. It doesn't matter. I'm not saving this. So... Oh, there's my announcement on the radio again. But anyway, that's how to build a robot. They're so much fun. I highly recommend doing it. I'm going to shut this one down and go back to the save earlier, where I hadn't used up all my resources. And then you can tell me what you'd like to see me do. So hang on a moment while I turn this off.